And Rush has been changed over the years. So if you've watched the video of Rush from a couple years ago, some of this stuff is new. So this area right here is called the three-way. You can go right this way towards Ann's Trail, or we can go left, which is east this way toward Canyon Hollow. Those are the two most common climbing routes on your way up to the top of Rush. And there's some alternatives. You can take a trail called Clark's, which is the quickest way up, but it's also the steepest and shortest way. It's a bit of a grunt to get up. The most fun is Ann's or Canyon Hollow, and today we're gonna do Canyon Hollow. And I'm not gonna show much of the climb. I'll probably just turn the GoPro off now until we get to the top of Rush and show you the Rush downhill.
That was funny.
If you're new to the channel, my name is Jason. I produce MTV Yum Yum, where I do mountain bike reviews, try to ride as many bikes as I can, but today we're just doing a little trail ride. Okay, we've made our way to the top of Canyon Hollow. It's about a 30-minute climb, or maybe a little more than that, not including the fire road, so I don't know. Plan on about 45 minutes this way to the top of Rush. Today I'm riding, I'll just tell you real quick before we get down on Rush, I'm riding the Ibis Ripmo, which is probably more bike than what you need, more travel than what you need for a trail like this, because Rush is like a blue flowy trail. But you know, the bike Tyler's on up there is on, he's on a Pivot Trail 429. That's a really good kind of blue trail bike. But if you end up doing higher speed stuff or occasionally ride chunkier stuff, then you would be glad to have a Ripmo. So the Ripmo works well. I'll just show you, this is the Ibis Ripmo. I might be the only person on planet Earth running a 2.4 Recon, Maxxis Recon kind of trail tire on a Ripmo. Most people are riding something a little bit bigger, but I like this bike with those tires for these trails, for this time of year when I'm not riding super chunky trails. And it just rolls a little faster. In any case, Chris at Salt Cycles has Ibis Ripmos, Ibis Ripleys, both in carbon and aluminum right now. He has a ton of them in stock, and they're between 15 and 25% off. So call Chris or Courtney or Jason over at Salt Cycles. They can fully customize the bike for you, make it super rad, or just get you a stock one at a huge discount right now. Call Chris at Salt Cycles, the number's right here. All right, let's get on Rush. All right, Rush Trail. This is the start of Rush right here. Got Zach and Tyler in front of me, riding the Ripmo today, so much fun. And if you've never ridden this trail, I think I already mentioned it, but geez, 21,000 users on Strava. This is a very popular trail, and for good reason, it's a lot of fun. Think of like a really easy like lift service bike park flow trail, only a lot smaller, narrower, like a normal single track trail. And very accessible. Lots of ways to come get on this trail and ride it. That's why it has so many users. I should probably mention that Corner Canyon is the foothills about 20 minutes south of Salt Lake City. So it's not like up in the mountains. Yeah. 20 minutes south of Salt Lake in Draper. The town is called Draper, Utah. And it's not difficult. My 10-year-old son rides this trail all the time. My 12-year-old daughter does. My wife rides it probably twice a week. There's no gap jumps or anything like that. It's just fast and flowy and fun. Exactly what mountain biking should be. Woo! Get a little loose there. Yeah, my kids love it when I bring them on this trail. Oh, I'm not sending that double.
Oh,
And there's no better way to start your day than with a mountain bike ride. All right, that's basically the top section. Rush has three main sections, the top, the middle, and then Lower Rush. Lower Rush is my favorite. Daniel's Corner here. Sick. This is the meadow kind of halfway through. This is my new favorite corner right here. No brakes.
I break. Tell me what to do. You're not going off.
Ah, I missed it. There's a couple of fun little jumps. We have to kind of look for them. Here's one. Then we'll come down here to a couple doubles that you could probably miss if you weren't looking for them. And Rush has been changed over the years. So if you've watched the video of Rush from a couple years ago, some of this stuff is new. Yeah. That's the fun little double I was telling you about. But Dustin Mallory, who used to be a mechanic at Go Ride, has done a ton of really good trail work and building some good jumps and stuff on this trail. And just really nice. I'm pretty sure that's who's been doing the work anyway. It just doesn't let up. Just berm after corner, after jump. It's really good. This is the last section right here in Middle Rush. And then we'll be down into Lower Rush. Nice. On a couple of these jumps and a few sections, it's kind of nice to be on the Ritmo, even though it's 147 millimeters of travel. But I ride this bike or this trail on my Ibis XC also, which is a total cross-country bike. So don't be worried about what kind of bike you have. Just come ride it and have fun. This is Lower Rush, kind of the fastest section of the entire Rush Trail. Well, it just changed the lips on those two jumps. None of us really know what to do on it yet. It was just to kind of jump you into the wall a little bit almost. I should have mentioned this at the beginning, but Rush, if you can't tell by now, is obviously a directional trail. Biker only, downhill only. So no horses, no hikers, no uphill traffic of any kind. And just let off the brakes and let it rip. Sick. This is my favorite section right here. There's a huge G out right here. Right there. Man, it's so good. Tyler's just dancing all over the place on his Pivot Trail 429. Hopefully this all comes through well in the video. There's two doubles right here. That one and this little one right here. And that's it. We get to the very section, that very lowest section called Baby Rush. This is all jumps through here. And then you're about done. Nice, Tyler. Get the legs burning, get the heart pumping. My heart rate will have been higher downhill today on Rush than it ever was climbing on Canyon Hollow. Being the 170s, high 170s, pretty much the entire time on this downhill. And then climbing, I keep it in zone two as often as I can, you know, 146. Not that you guys care. Sick! That was fun. That's it. Pops us back out to the three-way. You can go left to Ann's Trail, or right down to Canyon Hollow, or straight down to the Andy Ballard parking lot. We're gonna do Limelight too. That's the end of Rush. Okay, so the bottom of Rush drops into, I guess technically they call it still Rush because there's a sign right here that says Rush Trail, but it's called Limelight. And the dirt, you should know, is very different. Like, this is the trail that takes you back down to the parking lot where we started. The dirt is very different than the rest of Rush. It's all sand. So maybe just be aware that it's completely blown out, rocky and sandy. Very low traction. I don't know, I just don't want you to come and then find out that it's like not good traction at all. It's pretty sketch. And the lips on most of these jumps are kind of, right now it's October, so the lips on the jumps are kind of deteriorated, kind of worn out. One last plug for Salt Cycle, since they are the sponsor of this video today. They have this bike that I'm riding right now, the Ibis Ritmo, in stock and 15 to 25% off. Call Chris and order one today. They can custom build it for you. Dang it, missed my little manual section. I'll get it tomorrow. Call Chris, he can custom build it for you. They're the best bike shop in Utah. Such good guys. And they always have lots of inventory in stock, which is nice. Okay, so this is the section on the Limelight that has the biggest jumps. Again, the lips are kind of worn out right now, so they don't boost you as high as they used to, which also means they're not as scary as they used to be. But that's the first one. The second one you just saw Tyler yank up on, I kind of went wussy on it. And then the third one, the lip is completely gone. It's just kind of a little step down now. Anyway, and then the rest is just boosting corners back to the parking lot. Of course, I'm getting dropped by my buddies now, so I'm not thinking that I'm... There we go. That's a cute little line there, Tyler. You gotta try everything once, right? Whew. All right, that's Limelight completely blown out. It's much better in the spring when it has some water on it. It's been a dry summer. All right, well, thanks for watching today's trail video of Rush. I'm not hitting the big jump that they're hitting. I'm going over here where it's nice and safe. And yeah, thanks for watching today's video with me going on this ride. If you ever come to Draper, Utah, come ride Rush. You won't regret it. It's a lot of fun. Anyone can ride, any skill level can ride it. My name's Jason. I produce this YouTube channel called MTB Yum Yum. I normally do mountain bike reviews. But every once in a while, I gotta show you a trail that's so good, you gotta try.